So last time we were talking about the discretization of the multiphase equations, specifically the method called IMPES, implicit pressure, explicit saturation. And so what we had done is modified the mass balance equations in a way that we could get the so-called overall mass balance, or also known as the pressure equation in the IMPES system. And then we discretized that implicitly. So we did that last time. You saw the matrix equations for the implicit method. So now we'll consider the saturation equation, or what is essentially the The tip of my pen is not writing exactly. It's going to drive me crazy if I don't do this. I'm recalibrated now. Okay, so you can use the water or the oil equation for this. We typically use the water, which we'll write down the continuum form first. And what we're going to do, we're going to use an explicit discretization of the saturation terms. Okay. Now, the pressure terms we'll evaluate at the n plus 1 time step because we're going to assume that we've already solved for them. Right? We solved the pressure equation implicitly, so we have the input plus 1 pressures. We're going to plug those directly into this equation along with the n saturations to get the n plus 1 saturations. So then if we multiply through by BWI, so it's the formation volume factor of water at the ith grid block times delta T over phi, and group some terms, then we get this equation. We're writing it with the unknown saturation on the right, on the left, and everything else we know on the right. Okay, so if we write that in matrix form, it takes on a little different. If you remember, the implicit pressure equation had the same basic structure in matrix form. This explicit equation will look a little different than what we're used to. It's actually just a vector. Where D and C are technically matrices, but they're diagonal, just like the B matrix from before. So the II entry, the diagonal entry.